Hello, this is a demonstration of the aurex launch control XL template for U-He DIVA synthesizer. This allows you to control more than 130 parameters of DIVA on one controller. As you can see, this template comes with an overlay that clearly shows you all the functions and possibilities. I'll start with an overview of the main menu pages. In this template, you can select four menu pages: the main page, which is active when no other page is selected, the shift page, which provides additional control, the routing page, which lets you select and control modulation parameters, and model selection page, which lets you select the different oscillator, filter, and envelope models. Let's start with the model selection page. You can select the triple VCO, dual VCO, DCO, eco, and digital models with these buttons, and their respective filters are just on top of those. For example, if you would like to select a Minimoog type synth model, you just press the 3 oscillator button and the ladder filter above that button. If you want to emulate an MS-20, you need to select the eco model and the byte filter. For the filters, there are a few more possibilities which we'll come back to later. Of course, you can also mix and match models like this. As you can see, the LEDs reflect the current selected model, showing you which knobs are active and which not. The envelopes for both the amp and filter are selectable with these three buttons. You have one for the ADS type, one for the analog type, and one for the digital envelope. Let's go over the functions of the main page. In this mode, you can control the main parameters of the synthesizer which you currently selected. So you can control the tuning and wave of the oscillators. Then there is also a mixer section that lets you control the volumes of the oscillator and noise. You can control filter settings like cutoff, resonance, and filter frequency modulation. You have two controls for the patch volume and pan settings. And for each oscillator model, there are some very specific differences which are only available with certain models. For example, one of these things is the oscillator mix control for the dual VCO model. Okay, now the first four faders, they control envelope 2's attack, decay, sustain, or release state. And the last four faders control vibrato, light, the main output, and fine tune, which gives you extremely fine control over the last changed parameter. With the Launch Control XL's button rows, you can select the LFO settings. I'm going to assign LFO 2 to filter cutoff. And now I'm able to control the speed and wave of LFO2. You can hear how these values snap to synced tempo settings. In the shift page, the button rows now control the settings of LFO1. You can also control even more functions of DIVA with knobs now. For example, you can control the LFO's delay and phase settings or LFO1's rate to get an unsynced modulation. Note how the LEDs reflect this unsynced state. If I press one of the tempo synced rates, the LED goes on again. You can also control the master tuning and patch volume or pan modulation. The cutoff knob now controls the feedback, high-pass filter cutoff, or morph parameter, depending on the selected filter model. Resonance controls the high-pass byte peak, or provides modulation control of the morph knob when selecting the UP model. First four faders, now control envelope ones, attack, decay, sustain or release states. And the last four faders, control voice stack, glide 2, the lag slew rate and a modulation wheel. Let's go to the routing page. This page gives you a very user-friendly control for assigning modulation sources and destinations. You can select a modulation source with any of the buttons of the button rows. So you have envelope 1, envelope 2, the LFOs, key range, modulation wheel, pressure. So you select just one of those and you can assign it to any of the available destinations by turning a knob with a green LED. This works for both the main page and the shift page. And of course, different oscillator models also have different modulation destinations. You can also assign modulation sources for the quantize, lag, multiply and add modifications. To do this, you need to select one of these functions, hold it and press the routing menu button again. Notice that the LED goes from green to yellow to indicate the special state. Now you can assign one source for quantize and lag and two sources for multiply and add. After assigning these, the template automatically jumps back to the native routing menu. In this template, there are also a few special functions available. Let me show you what they do. You can select oscillator sync with the buttons on the right side of the Launch Control XL. This will activate the sync button and automatically sets up the correct tuning modulation settings to dial in sync sounds correctly. When deactivating sync, these modulation settings jump back to the normal active state. You can also select LFO's restart state in the shift page. Mono and legato modes are available with these buttons. And duophonic and polyphonic modes are available in the shift page. The envelope unify button lets you control both envelopes at the same time, which can be handy to quickly get your patch in the right direction. In the model selection page, there is a button to select the main filter models, the high-pass models, or both at the same time with the filter unify button. For each of the filter models, you can select the filter mode with the buttons on the side of the launch control. Also in this menu page, you have a reset button available for whichever oscillator or filter model you selected. Just make sure you're not in the shift mode. Let me show you how this works. To reset the oscillator knobs, I select and hold one of the oscillator models and press the knobs reset button. To reset the filter knobs, I select one and hold one of the filter models and then I press the knobs reset button again. As you can see, this resets the knobs state as well as the modulation routings. For the 3 VCO, 2 VCO and digital oscillator models, there is also a second reset button which only resets the modulation state buttons and nothing else. You can turn the whole template on or off by pressing these two buttons together. Or you can also switch to factory or user templates, just like you would normally. This is very handy because it lets you use the factory Ableton control template and the user DIVA template on one controller.